talk and challenging, interesting cases. Now comes the time for me to introduce Dr. Amal Ibrahim. And Dr. Amal Ibrahim is an associate professor of radiology in University of Ain Shams. She is a very dear colleague to me and a very active, knowledgeable staff member. Her talk will be about the role of fetal Doppler in high-risk pregnancy. Dr. Amal.
Thank you, Dr. Naveen, for a nice presentation. Thank you for the scientific committee to invite me. My presentation will be about the role of fetal Doppler in high-risk pregnancy. I first want to acknowledge my dear friend, Amal Ibrahim, lecturer of the Ain Shams University, who died in January this year. My friend provided me with most of the material in this presentation. Now we'll start with the definition of high-risk pregnancy. High-risk pregnancy is a pregnancy complicated by a disorder that may endanger the life of the mother, the fetus, or the newborn. What are the risk factors for high-risk pregnancy? Maternal age under the age of 17 above the age of 35 are more likely for high-risk complication, obesity, multiple pregnancy, some medical conditions like diabetes and hypertension. Now, the most important indications for tumor pregnancy are anemia, chromosomal anomalies, heart anomalies, monoclonal twins, placental abruption, or posterior pregnancy. So, tumor assessment of the placental and fetal circulation is essential for evaluating the fetal regime. What are the commonly investigated vessels during fetal Doppler? There are three arteries and one vein: umbilical artery, uterine artery, mediastinal artery, and the ductus venosus. Starting with the umbilical artery, normally the umbilical artery flow is low resistance flow with high elasticity and characterized by decreasing systolic diastolic ratio with advancing maternal age. Normally, mediastinal artery SD ratio is higher than umbilical artery SD ratio. What is the meaning of umbilical artery Doppler? First of all, we have to visualize the cord, select a free loop that is not close to a fetal cord insertion or placental insertion, then switch to the fiber Doppler modality, laser match the sampling gate. This is the way to obtain the from the umbilical artery, and this is the way to obtain from the veins. The umbilical artery wave is characterized by high diastole, while the venous wave is characterized by respiratory variation. So, again, this is a normal high diastole flow umbilical artery. To understand the concept of high diastole, this is the same patient, mediastinal artery waveform that shows low diastole flow, which is normal in fetal life. What is the abnormality in umbilical artery Doppler? Instead of having a high diastolic wave, this diastolic wave can be either lost or even reversed. If we find one of these signs, indicate a placental insufficiency. The second uterine artery investigated is a uterine artery. I have two good Doppler. If we go to one or right or left iliac fossa and to find the iliac vessel, the uterine artery is usually perpendicular to the iliac vessel. Applying the Doppler wave, this is the normal arterial wave of pain, again with high diastolic flow, especially after 24 weeks. Now, what is the shape of the abnormal uterine artery Doppler? Again, instead of this high diastolic wave, there will be either low diastolic wave due to high resistance or even reversal of this diastolic wave. The parameter used in umbilical artery Doppler is usually the resistive index. If the resistive index is above 0.6, indicate high resistance with low diastolic flow. Instead of this high diastolic flow, there is post-systolic notch. However, we have to know that post-systolic notch is normal before 24 weeks. but if this blotch is detected after 24 weeks, this indicates the presence of placental insufficiency. So umbilical artery, uterine artery Doppler, either low diastolic wave, inverted diastolic wave, or post-systolic blotch. The third investigative vessel is ductus venosus. What is ductus venosus? It is a means of connection communication between the umbilical vein and the RCC, which is later on will be obliterated to be ligamental venosus. What is the technique of ductus venosus Doppler? First of all, we have to take a section in the abdomen of the fetus, showing the umbilical vein. This is the stomach, spleen, liver, and this is the umbilical vein. Can be obtained in the self-axial or self-axial vein. This is the umbilical vein. Then we will do zooming. Then analyze the paraffin. Where is the ductus in this section? In this section, the ductus is identified by the most liaising bar of the most liaising bar of the valve. Or here is the central vein. This is the liaising bar also which communicates the umbilical vein with the ICC. What is the normal appearance of ductus venosus Doppler? It's an M-shaped wave, a characteristic M-shaped wave with systolic wave, diastolic wave, and atrial contraction wave, which is called the A wave. This is the normal appearance of ductus venosus Doppler. What is the abnormality then? The abnormality is the reversal of this A wave, like this case. This indicates the presence of right heart stress, leading to reversal of the A wave. The third event to be investigated is the meses cerebral artery. First, I'd like to mention that umbilical artery, triune artery, and ductus venosus, these three meses are normal situation show high diastolic flow, while the only meses that show normal, low diastolic flow is the meses cerebral artery. The technique of the meses cerebral artery survey, starting by axial section of the brain that show both the amine and the sphenoid wall, the meses-cerebral artery can be identified. Then the sphenoid wall on the proximal part of the meses-cerebral artery, and this wave can be obtained. Again, it shows low diastolic flow. Normally, there is high resistance in the cerebral circulation in the fetal line. The abnormality is presence of high diastolic flow. The interpretation of this is what is called fetal head spirit failure. In normal situation, meses-cerebral artery has high resistance to flow due to fragile capillaries and vessels during fetal life, with minimal anti-grade flow in fetal diastole. However, in pathological condition, there will be low resistance of the flow due to fetal head spirit failure because there will be compensatory increased cardiac output. If there is the center or the situation, there will be compensatory increased cardiac output to the fetal vein, to spare the vein, resulting in increased meses-cerebral artery diastolic flow. So, in the same condition, there will be decrease in umbilical artery diastolic flow with reversal of the normal situation. In presence of a center insufficiency, the meses-cerebral artery SD ratio will be lower than umbilical artery. To summarize, these are the diseases commonly investigated in fetal Doppler. The umbilical artery, this is the presence of placental insufficiency of fetal restriction. There will be low diastolic flow with high issue, is the issue. Later on, there will be absent diastolic flow or reversal. In uterine artery, the resistant index is usually in presence of placental insufficiency is higher than 0.6, and it can be absent diastolic flow, reversal diastolic flow, or post-systolic blotch. In ductus venosus, instead of the low resistance, high diastolic flow, there will be high resistance, where later on reversal of the A wave. And in the meses-cerebral artery, in presence of placental insufficiency, there will be high diastolic flow, which is reversal of the normal. And the MCA is the issue, will be lower than umbilical. To summarize, umbilical artery, ductus venosus, and uterine artery should have high diastolic flow, meses-cerebral artery, low diastolic flow. My take-home message is to prepare assessment of placenta and fetal circulation position for evaluating fetal well-being. A normal fetal MCA LD ratio should always be higher than umbilical arterial LD ratio. In pathological condition, will result in MCA distribution lower than umbilical. Thank you.